first time as far as live reading goes. Let's see. So, if you're here, just let me know. I can see the comments come up at the bottom of the screen. Here's technical difficulty numero uno. Is that you? Aw. Hi, Christine. Ooh, put on a mask. What? No, thank you. We'll wait till more join. Yeah, hiccup, I know. I wish she'd hiccup herself right to sleep. Hi. Say hi, Danielle. Hi, Christine. Say, I'm teething. I'm driving my mother crazy. Look. Who's that? Who's that? You might actually smile. Cranky butt. Okay, we'll start. I'm going to start with Christine because we had a prearranged agreement. So, Christine, already, you already know the answer to that. The answer would be no. All right? And I keep feeling like it's getting more wayward, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And there's more evidence to you that points in that direction that you need to really just start fresh. Do you have any additional questions, Christine? Not even Christine. I don't call you that. I call you Chris. Okay, Danielle. Yes, you already know who it is. There's two others. And the more foofy one. There's two. There's one that's an ex and one that's new. New-ish. In other words, you know of her. She's around in your circles. And there's a flirtiness that goes on. Yeah. The foofy one. And you know who says you need it. You need some puppy dog tails and some stuff like that. Some foofy stuff. Balance you out a bit. I'm just telling you what I pick up, girl. And you know everything that comes out of this mouth is the truth somehow, so. Hey. She's coming through loud and clear saying, that's what you need, Christine. And are you taking your medicine, Christine? No, Joanne. I can see the bottle, and it's on the counter. I know, and in my mind's eye, it's dusty. You need to pay attention to that. You know what? I feel like whoever this is going to make sure that you do stuff like that. And dust. Make sure you dust. For some reason, that's what she's bringing through, is the dusting. You need to dust, she says. Alright, let me move on for the sake of time. Let me scroll up. I have a few people that shared on my list. Let's see. Okay, I'm just going to call out so I can get these. Is Mariah Lynn here? I know. Hiccup. When I was pregnant, she had hiccups all the time. Mariah Lynn, Bonnie, Linda Spinner, Joycey, and Kayla Bergamasco? I think I said that right. Are any of you guys here yet? If not, I'm just going to start. Thank you. She's a cutie. Huh. Oh, your face has food on it still? Oh. That's because she doesn't like to wipe her nose or face, anything. She drives me crazy. Okay. Let's see. Hi, Christy Oliveira. I see you. Serena Steigler. Can you tell me how long my boyfriend Kenny and I will be together? That's really up to you, because I feel like the reason that you're still together is because you're trying to hold things, you're pulling everything together, but it's getting... Are you disagree? It's a lot of energy to do so. So honestly, it's really up to you as far as that goes. I'm getting that in the middle of the road feeling like, well, how long do you want to see, how long do you want to really pull at strings to keep it together? Hold on. Serena, did you hear me? You're welcome. Okay, let's see. Bear with me. I have to scroll up. Let's see. Hi, Stephanie. I haven't seen you in so long. Stephanie Martinez. Hi. Hi, Sarah. Larissa. I heard barely, and you really need to put more effort into it, because you have all the tools and you can do it, and you're kind of just happy right now with just making it, because there's other things pulling for your attention. But really, those things can wait, okay? But you will make it, but barely. And I feel like you do this a lot too, like you know where the cutoff line is, and you kind of like skim right on top of it. Hi, Jamie. Say hi, Jamie. Hi, Jamie. Hi. Look. Over here. Hi, Jamie. You're not interested? I have a pen on the bed and she wants it. All right, let's see. Okay, I'm going to ask again. Let's see. Joycey, Mariah Lynn, Bonnie, Linda Spinner, or Kayla, are you here? Emily, it's a girl. But it's funny because when I was pregnant, everybody swore it was a boy. I swore it was, well, I was carrying like a boy. And they'd ask me right up until the end, you sure it's not a boy? No, it's a girl. Are you a girl? On the outside? I know you're tired. Okay, let's see. Hi, Debbie. Hi, Anita. Hi, cousin Teray. Look, Teray was there when you were born. Say hi, Teray. Let's see. Okay. Let me go back up. Let's see. Thank you, Lisa Marie. Okay, Georgia. What, I don't know if you guys can all see this, but it says, what do you see me doing in my long-term career? You know, it's funny. I feel a combination of something for you. So it's something to do with arts and production of some kind, but also, but not directly. In other words, not being on stage and doing something, but as a project, if that makes sense. And they're making me feel like it's something to do with, budgeting of the project or finance, something like that, but it's definitely to do with the arts of some sort. Did you get that? Georgia? Mariah, you're next, because I know that you're on my list over here. Hi. Hi, Heaven. Give me 1 second. Let's see. Yeah, and Georgia, I've read for you before, and I still feel like the question you asked me about Linda Spinner, Christine's announcing your presence. That's funny. Hi, Linda. Yeah, I feel like it's all there's all this connection to it, and it's also part of, because you have some abilities and things, and it's all related to that. And there's a locus, a center or a locus of this as far as being, doing this career, finishing with the school part of it or something, where all the other things that we've talked about kind of are based off of that and kind of originate at that point. Okay, so let's see. Mariah Lynn. You said, will me and Johnny have a family together? So are you asking me, are you going to have kids, or are you asking me as far as your future with him? Of course I do, Debbie, but I'll get to that. You could have just messaged me. Kids? Yes. Two. Is that what you wanted to ask me, Mariah? Excuse me. Okay, I'm just going to keep going. Oh, you're welcome, Mariah. Linda Spinner, are you there? And, oh, Bonnie, you're on my list, too. So, but Linda, what do you want me to look? Yes, I was just thinking that right before you asked, before, right after I said that. Two boys, Mariah. And real, like, close together, like 2 years apart. Okay. So, Linda, what is your question, dear? And Bonnie, also, please write down your question, because you're on my list as well. Listen, I'm tired. I need to go to bed. I'm helping my mama. You're welcome. You're tired, I know. Papa's pooped. I said if they shared the announcement, that I would make sure that I got to them. But I think we'll probably get through to a lot. And I'm probably going to do this again, too. But hi, Bonnie. Do you have your question ready? Oh, and there we go. Yes, I do. But there's a long haul. I'm talking to Linda. There's somebody who knows something and doesn't want to say anything. But really, it's the right thing to do, and they should say something about it, if that makes sense. Hi, Victoria. Yes, I can contact people who have passed. Hi, Victoria. The list was to share the post about live feedings, but I'm pretty quick, so I should be able to get things through. Okay, Linda. So, yeah, but it's not going to be, I feel like you guys have been working, like, to try to quicken it up, but it's going to take a little bit longer. And I feel like if you stop putting pressure in that area, it will naturally happen by itself, if that makes sense. It's almost like putting pressure in that area, kind of, whoever this is, it kind of like gets standoffish about it. So if you just leave it alone and let those things work for themselves, that's what will happen. Oh, I see it. Victoria. Hold on. Okay. All right, Bonnie, are you there? Hi, Jana. Night, Debbie. I'm going to message you after this. I'm going to write it down right now because you know me. Mine's going in 20 different directions. Oh, wait a minute. Natasha Jane. I'm not getting to you just yet. I just wanted to let you know I almost spelled... Her name is Jane, and I almost spelled it that way. Yeah, Linda, and it will work, but like I said, ease up on the pressure part of it, and it will happen naturally. It'll open things up for you, okay? All right, out of you, someone in here has a relative that passed. Her name's Donna. I'm going to jump around real quick. Her name's Donna. Christine, you're funny. You already know. She's not going to give you that answer that easy. She said because she, Christine, she said she's more girly than she is. And there's only one of them out of whoever it is. You know how it is. She said, you have wings, you can fly. You know how to do it. Let's see. Okay, Bonnie, I saw you earlier. Are you there somewhere? And I didn't see your question. I'm looking for it. Oh, I see you, Bonnie. Bonnie, I don't want to... I think it's Ival? Ivall? Okay, what's your question, dear? I see you. Okay, Alicia, hold on to that. And is this that Donna, somebody who's on the other, who passed away? Hi, Karen. Yes. And I'm hearing that song, looking for love in all the wrong place. So it's not that you can't find love. It's that wherever your focus is as far as meeting somebody or doing things like that is not correct at all. So it just keeps not working, not working, not working. No connection made, no connection made. Okay. There's some sort of something you're going to. It's a rally or something. It's not to me a rally. I think of high school, but I don't know. But they're talking about a rally of some kind. So you're going to meet somebody there, and it's about June. This is for Bonnie. Hi, Gary. Hi, Becky. Hi, Christine Metros. Hi, Phil. Congratulations on the baby. I haven't seen you for a long time. Congrats. He's cute. All right, let's see. I just want to jump back to... you're welcome, Bonnie. I want to jump back to... Let's see. Okay, Alicia Estrella, you said that this Donna passed?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let me, because it'll come through quickly. So, this Donna, I'm seeing something over her head. So, she either had a handkerchief on or wrapped her head in, you know, wrapped her hair. Yeah. And she's talking about something about her eyes and her eye area. Is this connecting for you, Alicia? They said you're a cutie pie. Boogies and all. Miss, I don't want to wipe my face. Okay, well, I'll find whoever this is. So again, there's Donna. She has something, I feel like, the feeling I get is that she would ride a Harley or a motorcycle or something like that. That type of handkerchief. Okay? And she's talking about one of her eyes. There's a problem with it. Always running. Always running, and also, so there's a blocked tear duct, but also like a cataract type look where it's, you know, looks filmy type thing. Thank you. Oh, they love you. Oh, say, are you waving? Do the queens wave? Miss Sirius? Oh. Oh, she's winning points. Okay, let me... It could... Okay, Amber Lee. Does that make sense to you, though? So the deed... Because a DN name would come through like that, especially in this venue, and I'm trying to get things... Did he ride Harley and also have a cataract in his right eye? Because I keep pointing to my right. And also, I feel like there was blocked tear ducts, so it looked like he was not crying, but his eyes would weep. Oh, motorcycle's how he died. Okay. Well, let's keep going with that. He's telling me that he used to ride, like, he used to go on long trips on this motorcycle. Hi, Jenna Lee. Okay, Kelly, hold on to it, because I'm pretty sure this is where we're going with it. Because it sounded like a DN name to me. Okay. Where is... So, Amber, did you hear what I said? Always wore a bandana in the eye and he wore glasses, but I don't know about cataract. Okay. Was he very sensitive? Like, in other words, he was like this, somebody who rode a motorcycle, but very in touch with his emotional side type thing. Like, he was sensitive on the inside, but you couldn't tell by looking at him. Called him a big... Okay, so that is who's coming through. He's laughing at me because I said it was female, but it's energetic to me, so that's the way it feels to me. So, like, even when I do pregnancy readings, it's either I'm right on point, girl or boy, or... Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you. Or it'll be, you know, kind of like me. I very much think like a man, but I look very female, okay? So energetically, if I was to read myself, I'd come through male, if that makes sense. Can I give my cell phone number? I don't know why you'd want my cell phone number, just saying. Let's see. There's a Victoria in here who shared the post. Yeah, she's been kissing me like that since she was about 2 months old. And everyone used to tell me, oh no, she's trying to suck on your lip. I'm like, no, she's been kissing me just like that. She's like a little old soul. Not this job interview, Victoria, but the next one. And yeah, I saw your question. So not this job interview, but the next one. Okay? And I know you feel like you really want this one, but... This next one, in hindsight, you'll see that it's better. And I feel like it's about two weeks out, an interview. And also, I feel like you'll have two interviews for that one, if that makes sense. Let's see. Okay, I'm looking for Kelly. Very old soul. You're welcome, Victoria. Kelly, are you here? Kelly that shared the post? Okay, and then Natasha, who shared the post too. Oh, okay. Kelly, what's your question, honey? All right, Natasha, I'll get right to you after that. I'm waiting for Kelly to post her question. Natasha, post your question too. That way it'll be on deck, so to speak. Hi, Jessica. Those who shared the post about the live readings, I said that I would do, make sure I got to them. And besides that, I'm going to jump around and get as many in as I can. Kelly, anything from Nana? Okay. Okay, Kelly, and Art, who's the R name connected to you? You or her? Please keep an open mind, and I should back up and tell everyone that I see energy. People will ask me all the time, living or past. To me, it doesn't matter. My brother was murdered, and to me, he's not gone. He's still, you know, he's just different. So a lot of the time, what they'll do is, in order to open your mind up, is they'll bring through something that's random that you totally hadn't thought about. I get a lot of work connections where I'll ask who it is. They, you know, they can't take it, and I'm getting the information that, oh, it's so-and-so at work type thing. And it kind of like, you know, they'll laugh and say, oh, yeah, that's right. And that opens things up a bit, okay? So I'm hearing an R name connected to the situation. Oh! Where is it? Wait a minute. Okay. Okay, so that's the sister Rosie. Okay. Okay, and I'm also hearing something, a name that starts with... Okay, where are you from, Kelly? Or where was she from? Because I feel like this is a place name that starts with A. Damn, Christine, you're popular, huh? What did you do? Call all your boys and girls and bring them on in? Hi, Rena. Raina, excuse me. Kelly, are you still there? I'm writing these things down because if I have to, I can jump all around and still get to everyone because the information comes through so quickly. So let me go back and look. Natasha, he said, you are stronger than you think you are. You need to put your foot down and don't take any of that crap. Okay? You are stronger than you think you are. Also, he's talking about your sink is leaking or dripping or something, and he wants you to fix it. I think that's like a guy thing, okay? I feel like there's a drip or something in the sink, and he wants you to fix it. So that's a side note. But he said you're stronger than you are, than you think you are, okay? Oh, this is what she does. Yeah, my hair. Your face is filthy. Can I please wipe it? Probably not. Thank you, Lorna. So did you hear that? Natasha. Okay, I'm just letting you know that I'm on, you know, one of these devices. If I just so happen to use up all the battery, because this really does use a lot of battery, I will get the other device and come back on live, just so you know. I was going to do this for a half hour, but it seems like there's a lot here, so. Yes, he is, and yes, you got to put your foot down, and yes, you do know that, but you've had a suffered a lot of loss in your life, Natasha, and sometimes the easy thing is to stay. I know it sounds wacky sometimes, especially if somebody's not doing what they're supposed to do or lying all the time, but the harder thing is to go step in the threshold of the unknown, okay, and start a new life, and that's what he really wants you to do. Okay? Do I know what he's lying about? I don't, you know what he's lying about already. So you don't need to ask my confirmation, okay? That's all, a lot of this is, I don't like to do the whole dependency thing. We all have an intuitive ability, a gut feeling, and my purpose, you know, in this lifetime is to make sure, is to connect us all back together so that we can all, in varying degrees, be able to, you know, find our way in this world, okay? Get in touch with that internal compass type thing. Kayla, are you here? Is there anyone else who shared and I have not read for that is here right now? Hi, Keisha. Is that how you say it? Is it Keisha? Yeah? All right, Keisha, what? Ow, Jane, what's your question? All right. No more sharing after this, you guys, only because I'll be here. And can you not do that? Hi, Amanda. I shared twice. That doesn't, I hear you. That's funny. I almost want to give you points for that, but I won't be able to get to any. Hi, Joyce. You're on my list too, girl, for sharing. All right, let me go back up. Oh, okay. Keisha, what's your question, honey? Jane, can you not do that? Okay, Becky, I'll take that, but nobody after Becky, because you want to know. Okay. If your dad, Gene, is with your babies, is that the, who's the R name connected to that situation, Keisha? Yeah, little Joanne over here likes to pull hair and not wipe her nose, so her face is like, looking like who did it. Tell her. Tell Joycey. Oh, you are sweet. Oh, okay, that's the name I heard, that's funny, and I heard Robert. But what I usually do with names, because it comes through so quickly, is I'll back out. I'll say the R name, and then when you acknowledge it, then I would say it sounded like exactly. Okay, so that's an astounding yes. He is with your babies. Okay. All right. He's funny. See how, you know what he's telling me? He's saying, see how the baby's pulling on my hair and doing all that, and you know sometimes she likes to grab my nose, like he's the type that would just let them. He would just let them do it. And think it would, and probably laugh about it. Like, oh, it's so funny. Me, I don't laugh all the time. Yeah, you're so funny. You're so funny. Okay, so yes, he is. He, and he's talking about the month of February, the month of March, and the number 5. Okay, so March, February, and the number 5 are connected somehow. Listen, listen, Linda. Can you stop that? Can I keep it in a ponytail? All right, let me move on so we can get to everyone. Ashley, are you there? Hi, Jenna. Say hi, Jenna. Hi. Hi. Right there. Yeah, well, this beauty needs to not yank on my hair. All right, no. They don't think that's cute, you know. All right? All right, so Ashley, are you there? See, I'm doing meetings with my mommy. I pick up stuff too. All right, Ashley. So what's your question, honey? She can do what she wants, Joyce? Yeah, when she goes to your house, she can do what she wants, okay? Yeah. And as long as you keep her after you feed her up all the sugar for the required 2 or 3 hours, we have no problems. Huh. Joyce is every kid's best friend, isn't she? Ow. What are you doing inspecting? I always feel like my mother. This is why we don't have nice things. You guys destroy everything. What are you looking for? She's looking for the eye in the back of my head, I think. She's just showing... She's demonstrating for you guys that it is indeed there. Your sister did the same thing, you know. Ashley, honey, I'm waiting for your question. I if you had already wrote it up there, this thing's so long, it'll take me forever to get. I don't know about a hairstylist, but my hair isn't staying up. It needs to. All right, Ashley, if you can type. She said brains. You're crazy, I swear. She probably did. Are you tuning in over there? Huh? Is that why you try to bite my nose when you kiss me? All right, so Ashley, write down your question, honey. Juliet, if you're there. Okay. Wait a minute. I think we have, how many Ashleys do we have? Can you not pull that? All right, I have an Ashley Marie Belf. I need the Ashley who shared, that I wrote down, that shared the event. And I'll state this again, you guys. If by chance I use all the battery on this device, I'm going to switch over. But of course, I'll have to start up the live again. So just be looking for it. Ow. All right, so Ashley that shared, I need to know which Ashley that is. And then Juliet, Josie, and Anita. I'm going to have to start writing initials on the end. Especially with a name like Ashley. So I'm looking for Juliet, Josie, Anita, Paige, Becky, or Carol. Ow, Jane, that really hurts. Ow. You want me to do it to you? Hi, Josie. What's your question, honey? Where are you going, Joyce? To take medicine, NyQuil, and go to bed? Okay, Ashley, I need your question. Let me look at this list. Wait a minute. Okay, I gotta see more. Okay. Oh, we're at 10%, so we may just use up all this battery. Okay, Juliet. Juliet Ann, you're the one who shared. Do you see anyone around me? Okay, the first thing that's coming through, there's a couple females, but the one that's primarily, I feel like, coming through is, it's an older female. I want to say it's an aunt of yours, okay? And I feel like it's an R name connected there, too. I see your question, Ashley, okay? I'm going to write it. Hi, Scott. So, Juliet, did you hear what I said, honey?
Not.
All right, Paige, let me write that down. Okay, not sure about the R, because sometimes it's the way it's coming through. Okay, what's the yes for, Juliet? Hi, Tanya. Scott, you're funny. You've asked us, like, okay, it's all right. But my answer is still the same. And there's good reason for it. Okay. Yeah, it's the aunt that's coming through loud and clear, too. And I feel like she would have no problem saying, you know, this is how you should do things. And this is da-da-da, like, loud, you know, and made herself known type thing. Okay? And you know what? Is it your Nana? Okay. She's sitting, like, sitting in a rocking chair back and forth, kind of like, mm-hmm, just letting her talk, the aunt. No way. That's cool. But the R name that came through, it's like something, it's either R or it sounds like Ita at the end, I-T-A, because it sounds like Rita, but sometimes I'll hear, because it comes through so quickly, the ending sounds like I-T-A, Ita. Jennifer, I'm going to say absolutely yes to you real quick, only because that name has already come up if you look at all the comments under on this feed. So that's how spirit works all the time, okay? It's what binds us and what's common with all of us, and that's kind of how it works. And like when I do group readings and things like that, you'll see, I'll sit there and I'll say, you know, oh, that's funny, your grandmother, da-da-da, and your grandmother, da-da, and connections that way, okay? And that's how spirit likes to come through. Oh, Elizabeth. Okay. I don't know where the ITA, but it sounds like Rita, Ida, something with the ITA sound. So just hold on to it. And like I said before, a lot of the time they'll bring things through your work situation, you know, I don't know, your neighbor next door. And they're basically saying, hey, I see what's going on. Okay. All right. Let me scroll back up too. Okay. Wait, I wrote these down. Ashley. Your mom, right? Hold on. Yeah. Your mother says... She says you're very sensitive, okay? And I feel like she's saying that lately you've needed her a lot. and she's been there with you, all right? Do you have a dream catcher or something that looks like a dream catcher? You're welcome, Juliet. Oh, so Ashley Bellflower, that was for you. Did you hear me? Oh, and there's the Elizabeth with Kylie. Okay, well, that might bridge over into that. But right now, I'm looking for Ashley Bellflower. And you were asking me about your mother? Okay, well, she's talking about that. Do you go there sometimes and you're over there? Because I feel like it moves by itself. Like, there's no wind, no anything, and it, like, goes like this. But I have one in my room right up here, but it goes back and forth like this. Left to right, left to right. Yeah, that's her. There's also a whistle-type sound that I hear that's her. Almost like when you have those wind chimes outside, the silver ones, and the wind catches it just right, or like on a bottle, when you do that. And I don't exactly know what she's doing or why it's coming through like that, but that's a signature thing because I don't get that, I don't hear that very often. Okay, that's her coming through for you. Also, something about a book. Did you read a book recently, Ashley? Not as much what? Oh, not as much since I see what you're saying. Okay. Also, a book. Did you buy a book or a book caught your eye or something about a book? And I feel like you haven't read it yet. In my phone, my other device just said ding ding, so I'm telling you that's what it is. So if it hasn't happened, there's a book that's going to catch your eye. All right? There's something, there's messages in it for you from your mom. All right? Hi, Crystal. All right? Let's see. Paige. Hi, Josie. I've got you on my list. Paige. Talking about the health condition and the message from your mom. All right. Are you there, Paige? Look at my hair. How am I going to operate like this? Excuse me. Excuse me. Hi, Carrie.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I got to read.
Very good. You happy?
You happy with Mama?
Josie, my video, my what? The video ended. I'm still here. A train sound with her hands. Really? Is that why, like the choo-choo, like the woo-woo, that part, Ashley? You haven't read it yet. Well, it's from your mom, so get to it, girl. You're welcome, Ashley. All right, I'm looking for Paige, who asked about her mother and her health condition. I can see I'm going to end up having to go to another device with this. Josie, you can't hear or see me. Everyone else can. Okay. Josie, type in your question so that I make sure I'll get to you and somehow we'll get the message to you, okay? Hi, Becky. But I'm still looking for Paige. You asked if there was a message from your mom and something about health. I don't want to have to scroll back up because we'll be here. Wait a minute. Paige Young. I'm pretty sure. Please don't pull my hair, Jane. All right, hold on, you guys. I'm gonna plug this thing. Can you not do that, please? Like, really? Hold on, you guys. Let me grab the charger for this. No. Jane. No, thank you. No, thank you. Sugar. Let go. Thank you. Hold on, you guys. Let me just double check this thing. Hold on. Why is it not working? All right, let go. No, 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 no cords for you, girl. Okay. Oh, all right, where were we? Now I don't have to restart the video. Let me scroll to the bottom. All right. Okay, hi, Paige. So your question was, hold on 1 second, I gotta shut. So your question was about your mom and health issues, yes? Hi, Paige. Excuse my baby hairdo. Go ahead. The health issues, okay? Is this something you have to go to the doctor for regularly? Okay, because I feel like it causes lethargy. Oh, you have your toddler beside you? Then you know exactly what I'm going through. I usually have her everywhere. Half the time she's in the bathroom with me, sitting on me, I have to go to the bathroom. Okay, it causes lethargy, and I feel like it's just, there's this unmotivated thing about it, too. Okay, Josie. Does it cause, is there a fertility issue with it, too? Okay, hi, Rachel. She wants you to change your diet, all right? And as much as I feel like there's a certain sugary things that you really, really, really enjoy, okay? You need to stay away from dairy. You need to, Josie, it must be because there's something, okay, Paige, the fertility thing is because it's either that or it's down in that area, and also because I feel like it drains you to the point where it's hard for you to, like, keep up with the kids. Damn, Christine, you know everybody, huh? Hold on. Yeah, why don't we try holding on to this instead of dropping it? You need to have some diet change. So you need to eat more green leafy vegetables. You need to stay away from the dairy and cut out the sugar. And that fake sugar, too. Diet soda, anything like that, even gum, all that stuff that has all that aspartame in it, you need to stay away from that. That is so bad. It's bad for everyone, but I'm feeling in your case that it's really, really not good for you at all. And it's funny you say that because I feel like they can't give you a firm answer as far as what this is, what this problem is. Hi, Jay. Okay, Paige. So your mom said not to lose focus. Don't lose focus, okay? Don't lose focus. And she wants you to be proactive as far as your health goes, okay? And that the first step would be the no sugar, the no fake sugar. Hi, Carol. What does that say? Trinan? Who? The sugar, you need to eat more green leafy stuff. You definitely need to eat red meat, okay? Because you need the protein and the iron. And that will alleviate some of this lethargy type stuff, all right? And water. Water, water, water. You shouldn't be worried because it's only going to go up from here, okay? You have what? Rachel, water, yeah. You know that meme, water fixes everything? Pretty much. B12, mm-hmm. That's for metabolism boost, exactly. That's in addition to, there's a deficiency there too. Yep. Oh, I see what you're saying. Hi, Carol. So, hold on. Okay, Paige, now I can't read what it says. Okay, now I'm worried. I have what does it say? Yeah, that is to do with it, okay? And it's an iron thing. It's also a water thing. They're telling me to make sure you eat plenty of get your potassium levels up with the bananas, all right? That will help a lot. And also, you can look into CBD, is it CBD? Like cannabis oil type stuff, okay? That would help immensely. And Melissa says, check out AIP protocol because she's a physician's assistant. Check out AIP protocol for RA, hits on diet. Okay? Oh, Michelle, of course he's funny. It's funny because their personality shines through so much, all right? He said, hello from heaven. That was Michelle and Amanda. He's like, he's going like this. He's like, hello. He's funny. Autoimmune protocol diet, Melissa says. Listen, baby cakes. All right, let me see who else. All right, Josie. Oh, you're welcome, Paige. Josie, are you there? What are you looking for? The book? Where do you put it? Yeah. All right, so Josie's on deck. Let's see. I have Becky. You're welcome, Paige. Becky, Josie, Anita. Becky, Josie, and Anita. Carrie. Hi, you guys. Give me 1 second. Let me just try to get through these, the shares from earlier. And we can bang out some stuff. Hold on. Okay, and everyone who is messaging me, because I'm looking at... I will get to those after we're finished with this, okay? All right. I have a male coming through whose name sounds like Andrew. Can anyone take this? He's younger. And he's making me feel like he had emotional issues because he keeps, like, he's going like this with his head all the time. Can anyone take that, please? And he's talking about July and June and the number 12. I know, that's what he wanted to do, Michelle. He's funny. He's like 10-4, roger that. He's a trip. And my brother's hilarious too, so you know that these two goofballs are up there right now. They're cracking up too. Especially with this setup. Okay, no, it's not. This is somebody that passed that had emotional issues, all right? And I feel like his actions caused his own death. This Andrew would be passed. It's an A name. Does it sound like Andrew? Because that can happen. So if everything else fits, you guys, don't dismiss the obvious. Think about when you were a kid and you know how you go underwater at the beach and you try to talk to your siblings and you could just barely make it out. Well, that's kind of how it is here. And they talk extremely quickly. Yes, Danielle, I am. Because I should already have known that a half hour would never be sufficient. Who's yes? Marguerite. Yes, you what? Okay, so, but does everything else make sense? He's young, he had mental issues, and I feel like he took his own life, okay? I know about Aaron. You got Kerry. All the regulars that, you know, all you guys that in everyday life, I kind of, they already know to, like, hold on a second. Okay, but the A name, it's got, everything's got to match, in other words, okay? But if there's one or two things that are a little bit off, it could be the way I'm interpreting it. So it's Andrew. He's making me feel like he had, you know, he could never get his mind to work correctly. He was like, I don't know if it's hearing things all the time or just constantly being pushed into that depressive state, but he took his own life. Yeah, suicide. Okay, so that's who where we're going with it. Yeah. I thought it said, he said Andrew. Okay. Who is this to you, Marguerite? Yeah, exactly. I didn't want to say it like that. And it's in the front, too, because I can see it. I still get, you know, I still have that thing where I feel bad about saying things like about the way it happened. Even though I should just say the way it comes through, but it's partly because I've been through grief myself, and so maybe I'm more sensitive to it. Okay, so he's definitely coming through. Did you just recently get in a relationship, Marguerite? Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what he showed me. Did you just recently get into a relationship? Because he's talking about the boy. I did, Josie. I saw it, but I'm in the middle of this, but my phone's just ding-dong like Donkey Kong over here. Okay? But I'll get to them. Marguerite, did you hear what I asked? Okay, well, who then? Because to me, he said the boy. So that makes me think that, you know, like, to me, that would be like a new boyfriend. So whatever that means to you, he's talking about the boy. Thank you. She can be adorable if she stops ripping my hair out. Damn, Christine, you really do know everybody. Oh, okay, so that's his god. All right, okay, because he was talking about the boy. See, and that's why I should just say the way it comes through sometimes. Because, of course, my logical mind that is dealing with the baby decides that it's going to make sense of it, okay? He wants me to tell you that does not feel like that anymore. That as soon as it happened, boom, he said his grandmother came to get him. And all of that stuff was just an instant, like, lifted weight, literally. Like, in other words, they call it light as a feather, just instantly, whoop. Like, oh, this is, it's almost like, oh, this is how it's supposed to be type thing, okay? He wants you to know that, because he says you think about him a lot. Especially the way it happened, and you feel like he didn't have anyone there for him, all right? All right, let's move on. Let's see. I don't know if Becky replied, because there's like 1,000 replies here. So I'm just going to see where I go to. All right, hold on. Gail's your family, Christine? Okay, well, she's my family, you know, by marriage. My Uncle Spanky was married to her sister. Well, common law. There's somebody, wait a minute. Two faces behind me on the wall. I'm not surprised. You know that they don't. I can't even go to the bathroom by myself. Okay, Carla Michelle Rosado, are you still there? That's funny, Amy. My mother's Scottish, and she talks like this. She says, Joanne. Oh, hi, Becky. Hi, Kaylin. Okay. Let's see, before we get all caught up here. Becky, what did you want to ask, hon? Okay, there's more than one Becky in here. So the Becky that was the last person I said to share the live, to share the event for live. But I'm going to answer because I know there's two Beckys. I'm going to do it real quick. So you got about 6 months, Becky Cardoza. You got about 6 months, all right? It's like August, September, okay? The summertime starts to look up, but it's going to be August, September when the fall starts, where things start to, like, really kind of settle for you, all right? All right, and then Becky LaFave, what do you need to know, dear? Oh, I got it. Thank you, Christine. I feel like I have, like, administrative assistants already, besides this one over here who likes to administratively do my hair. You're welcome. Oh, no, I know, Becky. It's okay. Becky LaFave, who said it was me. What's your question, honey? Hey. All right, look, colors. Say hi to Nicole. You want to talk to your grandfather that passed, yes? Bye, Paige. Huh? What does that mean? Well, all right, is that his name? Is that what you're saying? Oh, okay. Did he wear glasses? Okay, he wore glasses? That he pushed up like this all the time? Okay, did he tinker a lot? Like, I'm hearing the word tinker. Like, tinker with things, you know, like putter around and tinker. Yeah. Did he like trains? Or something like that? Like, locomotives is the way it's coming through instead of sounding like train. I tried to say train in my mind, and it's like locomotive. Even like have one at Christmas time type thing? Okay, so that is him. Like, I feel like he's like... I'm hearing that song. He's like, I don't want to grow up, but I'm a Toys R Us kid. So in that respect, he was like that, like a young soul type thing. Oh, wait a minute. No what? Yes to the locomotives. No to the Christmas train. All right, Kayla, why can't you view live chat? Oh, that's what you're saying. That was your song. That's what you meant by, like, you can't believe that came through like that. All right, you got to back up. No to both what? Because it may be the way that I'm interpreting it. So I like to perfect my stuff. Listen, it's not letting her watch it. Tell her, is she on a cook? Okay, so no, he didn't play. No to the trains, even though he's saying locomotive. Okay? And I'm getting that old school train type feeling. Not the kind they have these days, but like the kind that's old school. It's not letting her, Carrie. Tell her to try to switch a device or go on. Tell her to like the page and see if she can. Oh, I think she did. She doesn't have a PC or something different, tablet, something that's besides whatever she's using. Okay, Becky, let me go back. Oh, that could be true. It could be her Wi-Fi. Tell her she might need better signal because I know it won't let me. It'll tell me, like, you can't do whatever. You can't do the live thing because of the connection. Yeah, locomotion, like locomotives. It's either that or he's actually talking about actual riding trains back in the day. Like, I wonder, would he be that old? How old was he? Or how old would he be now, Becky? You had to download the app? Oh, she got it, Carrie. I just saw a message from her pop up. Why do they say that? Because you're just... Listen, I noticed that when my brother was murdered and my gifts just basically took off quantum leap style, I noticed in hindsight, okay, once I understood what was going on, exactly that it had been going on the whole time, it was just my perspective that needed to change, okay? So it's dismissing the obvious. My general rule of thumb is, it in your daily life, if you ever see anything, experience anything, and you say to yourself, wow, that's weird, wow, that's odd, wow, that's strange, pay attention, okay? Because that's exactly what they'll do to get your attention. All right, so that's that answer, Marguerite. All right, all right. Where's your bubby? Okay, 80-something now. I am getting that distinct, like, what's that movie? It's a Christmas story, but it's not that's not the name of it. What the heck is it? What's that Christmas, you guys, anybody, that Christmas movie, it's black and white, and there's a train, and at the scene at the end with the lady kissing the guy, and her leg goes back up, and type thing. What's the name of that movie? No, not Polar Express. I'm talking old school movie. It was like in the 40s or 50s, so it's a black and white movie. 49th Street, is that what it is? Okay, because that's not the... Alright, that's the scene I am getting, okay? And it's coming through in black and white. It makes me feel like he wants me to connect it to this love story thing. Could be Christmas, so I'm in here. I feel like it's a Wonderful Life. That's it, Scott. Thank you. Nope, it's Wonderful Life. That's the movie I'm looking for. And it's a Wonderful Life, but they always play it around Christmas time. This is what he's showing me, okay, in this black and white thing, and I get a love story feeling from it, all right? And he's talking about locomotives. Did he say coins in a jar? Becky? Where is it? Okay, yeah, so I definitely... So you need to watch that movie then. And maybe there'll be things that you can connect better. But that's the scene I'm getting. And there's a scene... He wants to connect it to Christmas, I'm telling you. And a train that goes around a tree. I don't know if when he was younger he had that or something. But I'm telling you... Anything that comes out of this mouth, I've gotten, you know, a year later, people hit me up with an email about it. So I've learned to just, I know that it's for you and that it fits somehow, okay? But yeah. Did he do something like this to your nose? Like to your nose?
Okay.
Oh, she's still up. She, you kidding me? Oh, you're sorry. That's the other thing too. All right, so that's how he's connecting it all, and we're trying to fit things in. No, I'm speaking. If it's to who, whomever is the recipient, I'll make sure that you know it's you, okay? All right, Becky. I'm happy I can make that connection for you, okay? Is there anybody else that shared that's here now that I haven't answered their question yet? Kayla, all of a sudden you download the app and you're a pro, huh? She's talking to Becky now. Yeah, did I have Bianca on here? Was she, Mama? Christopher, well, because I talk to you all the time, Kayla. All right, hold on. Slow down. All right. So, Matt, Steve, and Aruda, you're telling me that you shared the event? Christopher Whitney, you're telling me you shared the event? Christine Cunningham, are you telling me you shared the event too? Okay, Jennifer, I can see your comment. So, Jennifer, let's get to you first because I can see that. You all right? So, Jennifer Marie Cartwright, what is your question? All right, Matt, then you're next. Writing this down because we're going to get way beyond it. I might have to do another session because... Okay, I'm not taking any new shares, all right, from way back before because I'll have to do another one. So if you guys didn't understand that, please understand it now, and I will do another one. And what I'll do is for the people who did not hear me or did not really realize that, I'll make sure that we get to you somehow, okay, in another live video. But if I don't get this kid to bed at some point, it's going to be a lovely night for Mom. You guys know everybody. All right, hold on. Hold on, James. All right, Jennifer, did you put any? Oh, I see it. Okay, I'm hearing new prospects, Jennifer Marie Cartwright, and a few different areas, okay? One would be career. Also discovering something that you didn't know or you have an idea that you can do, but you really haven't looked into it yet. Okay? That's coming up. Jennifer Marie Cartwright, do you read cards? I see, Kayla. On a side note, Matt, Steven, Aruda, your birth mom has passed, yes or no? Because I'm trying to put these on deck so we can get through them. Do you read cards, like tarot cards, Jennifer Cartwright? Okay, Matt, I got you. You're next. Hi, Carol. If you want to wait, I can get to you. I'm writing everything down. Sometimes just the interaction and hearing the messages and hearing things come through for everyone is, you know, a healing in itself, to be honest with you. Knowing that it's possible is really not just possible. It happens. It's probable. Oh, she's ready for, yeah, she's just, Carla's been waiting. Carly, I got you right after Matt. So I'm looking... No, don't worry about it because she's going to be... I know this kid. She's the kid that if I move two inches to the left, she's looking right at me, trying to kiss me. Yes, this is live right now. Jennifer Marie Cartwright, are you there? Oh, okay. All right. Well, Jennifer Marie Cartwright, that's what's about to open up for you because that's exactly what I heard was you're going to discover exactly how in-depth that ability is, okay? And probably from your interaction here, because I'm about to tell you that there are many Facebook groups, development groups that you can join where you can feel open to learn and discover these truths and also practice without feeling like, you know, the pressure's on you or you're being judged, okay? So that's the message for you. Matt, that's crazy. I've had a lot of the readings today with birth moms in it. She died young, Matt. Jamie. Yeah, I know. He said birth mom. Okay, she died young, yes? Okay, wait. Why am I getting... Go looking out over there. I think you say Yamari. No, you are. She's looking out for you. All right, so Stephen Aruda, there's an M name connected to you, female. It's on your mom's side. I want to say it's a step above her, so it would be her mother or her great, or her mother or her grandmother. All right, Matt, I'm just waiting. You're not... Okay, I understand that's why. But this is the way she's coming through with it. All right? She's making me feel like the situation or the way that your birth came about was not an ideal situation. And maybe things that maybe, you know, if I speak to you on a private level, we'll get into... Excuse me. But ultimately, she wants you to be happy. Okay? And stop wondering why and woulda, coulda, shoulda type stuff. All right? And to for you to know that you write your own story. And every day you wake up and you have a chance, okay, to start a new page in your life. All right? And life is what you make of it. All right? And that's her message to you and what she wants for you. She's just talking, and she's talking about the month of June, by the way. Excuse me. All right? Carla. Oh. Are you there, Carla? Yamari, where's Carla? All right. Wow, she's got a whole fan club of people saying she's here. That's crazy. They really look, a third one. You guys really, a fourth one. Oh my God, you guys are hilarious. Yep, and hi, Carla. So what's your question, dear? Go easy, kid. Don't forget that a lot of the time when I'm in that zone, I miss that. And that's why I said, please just post it again if you posted it before, because it's way, way, way up. Hi, Lynn. Excuse me. What's your question, Carla? Oh, you're going to do my hair again? Hi, Shanice. Okay. I feel a lot of blame around that death. All right, Carla? She's talking about walking in the park. Does that make sense to you? Going for a walk in the park? And then she's talking about what sounds to me a name like Anthony. So it sounds to me, so it's either Ann, Anthony, it's coming through quickly, but that's what it sounds like to me, but it's that A name type thing. Oh, yeah. And she's making me feel like you guys talked about death. Is this true? That's a new comforter, girl. Oh, I don't want you to do that. That's my favorite pen. I love that pen. Oh, you kissing me is not paying it. Okay, so that's how she's connecting it. And did you guys talk about death at some point? All right, so she... Okay, she's talking about butterflies and fairies. I'm seeing, like, fairy wings. But I heard butterflies, and then I'm seeing fairy wings. So can you take that, Carla? I don't need that. Okay, and when she's talking about it, and this is the second time that this has happened. Oh, okay. And then something about fairies, too, like pixie. The way it came through was like pixies. So I don't know if it's like pixie tails, pixie dust, something like that. All right? And then she's talking about, and this doesn't happen often where they talk about a day of the week. She's talking about a Tuesday. So something about a Tuesday is important. All right. Okay. Here. Oh, okay. Literally, like, the Tuesday coming up? Oh, that's wicked funny. So you guys must have referred to it like, oh, you know, on so-and-so's birthday on Tuesday. That's why, okay, that's why she's bringing up Tuesday. Do you make wishes for her, like, in a wishing well? Like, people throw coins in, but do you do it and, like, make a wish about her? Because she's showing me somebody throwing coins in a well. Or something like a wishing, like, stuff. Go easy, would ya? Oh my God, you wrote on your face, Jane. Okay, she's acknowledging that. She's also talking about the sixth. Hold on one second. The sixth of a month. Take that. Yeah, she does come through to you in your dreams. And I feel like you wake up and it's like you remember that she was there, but you really can't remember what it was about. She also said that she comes, sometimes you sit on the bed, you're laying on your side, like laying on your bed with your hand under your head like this. And she comes and she does the same thing, but like right in front of you. And she's right in front of you. Yeah, you haven't had a dream in a long time because you're too focused on it. And that's for everybody here. Like, if you focus so hard on if you focus on this one little thing right here, you're going to miss everything else. And it's the same thing with energy. So it's constricting the flow when you focus on one thing, all right? So what you want to do is just open your mind up to the possibility and forget about the why or the why not, and things will come through better. Okay. Carol, are you still there? You're welcome, Carla. Hold on, Mama. Where'd it go? Yeah. Jenny Lynn Tudor, yes and no. Yes and no. Oh, wait, she just asked a question. How do you do live readings often? No, this is the first time I did a live reading like this. I've done a live reading where it's just an individual reading. I just pick who I'm drawn to. I told, in this case, and I have to limit it the next time, that if you shared the event post, that I would make sure I got to you. And I think I've pretty much done all of that. Yeah, yes, Carol, there's definitely a guide around you. His name's Peter. He's funny. He's like, because he's very serious. There's another one with him, one tall guy, he's Peter, another short guy. His name's like Darren, something like that. And he's like Peter, Pumpkin Eater. So he's a jokester, all right? And the tall one's kind of just kind of serious all the time. You know what it reminds me of? That movie with, what's his name? He played the blind guy and the young college guy, the serious one, comes to take care of him or whatever. What the heck's his name? But that, I can't remember the name of the movie, so if somebody remembers it, they can pop up with it. But kind of like that, and he just wants to, you know, because he thinks he's going to die, so he's just living his life, and the other one's just, like, really a tight ass, to be honest with you. But those are the two that I'm picking up that are with you right now. Yeah, it's like, it sounds like that DN sounding. Hold on. Yeah, Scent of a Woman, that movie. Watch it. A Carol Johnston. Paige D'Souza. Is there a name like Corey, Rory, or something like that connected there? Could be living, could be past. Connected to you, the situation. Yes, Peter, and it sounds like, it's like Daryl, Daniel, that DL sound. Hold on one second. Oh, thank you, Jane. Thank you. Okay, Paige, and this is for anyone else. When I ask for, you know, is so this thing connected? Don't offer up the information. Tell me as little as possible, because my whole point in this is to perfect my craft. And the more information you tell me, the more they're going to try to validate. And they've got to go around now all those things that you've told me in order for me to feel like the connection's been made satisfactorily. Okay? So, and I like to perfect it. So I'm getting bits and pieces of information and energy from all different sources, because up there it's like a 360 degree vision. All right? Whereas down here, we see things in a timeline. I got up, I brushed my teeth, I took a shower, I ate breakfast, I went to work. That's not how they kind of, you know, it's like putting together a mosaic. There's a D name connected there too, and I feel like it's bouncing off of that Daryl Daniel thing. So there's something connected with a D name, Paige. Okay. Your brother's death was unexpected, yes? Okay, to the person who just commented, whose last name looks like it's Black, I'm not the one you really want to say stuff like that to, number one, because I'm extremely confident, and I do know that, and that won't get you anywhere to try you, because the truth does not need proof, just saying. Yeah. Could be your dad, and yes. What was the yes to? Because now they got a little bit bumped. Paige, what are you saying yes to? Please just bring me back to where I was. Thank you. Kayla. Yeah, okay, so yes, thank you, Michelle. yeah, and it just distracts from exactly where I'm going. I can always get my way back, but it's one of those things. It's trying to throw me off. Like, really? What the hell's the point of that? To prove I can ride like the best of them? Anyway, he's making me feel like there's definitely blame somewhere for his death, Paige. No, I didn't say I asked to know very little. I said refrain from giving me bits and pieces of information, okay? And there's a reason for it. You want to know what the reason is? My brother was murdered. So this is how I think. I think in terms of what would somebody need to tell me to individualize a reading? Because everybody always says, do they have any messages they want to hear that about the love? We all, how, 90, it's like DNA, 99.9999% of the time, we love our we love those that we're connected to on the other side, right? So that's what unites us all. I want to individualize it. I want to get the personality, dates. I want to get things that are specific to the person so you know that that's your loved one coming through and that there's love that binds us and the connection is always there. That's my point, okay? So he's making me feel like there's two people that were involved around his death that are connected, okay? And he's making me feel like he's taller than both of them, Bianca. If that makes sense. Because I see him here, like where I'm standing, but they're like one here and one here. Good thing we have a snow day tomorrow. Huh? Bianca, are you there? Yeah. Oh, wait, I didn't see it. It didn't scroll. Hold on. Okay, your dad blames himself. Yeah, but I feel like there was two other people involved. I don't mean the blame from your dad. I mean, because that's, honestly, that's a natural stage of grief. But I feel like there's two others around him or were around him when this happened. They're involved somehow. And they're I don't know why he's pointing that out, but I feel like they're shorter than him. One's really short, and then one's like... hold on one second, you guys.
Let me grab her bottle.
Okay. Whew. Now I can really bang through some stuff. All right. Where is she? Yeah, he was with two people that night. Okay. So he's coming through and he's... Is there some sort of silver frame or something silver that has like your initials and his initials in it or something like that? I don't know. It reminds me of a, like pewter or silver, and I don't know why it's flashing in my mind as a frame, but then also as something like round. Does this make sense? Hi, Lisa. Looking at your Facebook to get all this? If you think I have time to juggle a baby... my parents, Mia, and all that shit, and do this still, and I have my degree, you out your tree, girl. Like, what? Yeah, that's what I'm doing. I'm looking at Facebook to get, come on, man. If you're that far beyond it and that far, like, seriously, you know what? Do me a favor. Go read my reviews or ask all these people here that just, the information comes out of where? Oh, yeah, that's right. My mind, because I worked for it. Thanks. But let's see, because if you guys keep throwing things out of left field to interrupt what I'm trying to do here, which is impart healing and things like that, then I'm going to get pissed off. And me, emotionally charged, is an acute thing at all. Hi, Darren. And honestly, if you are investing your energy and time in here to even listen and do these things, but you're interrupting to make, like, you know what I'm saying, to throw monkey wrenches, then you need to go back to the circus. And that's just how I feel. Because that pisses me off when these people actually need healing. All right? And you're over here trying to detract and steal energy. That pisses me off. They're not getting to me. I know what I'm doing. I'm very, very, how do you say? My aim is extremely on point. I know what I'm doing. Let's see. Oh, okay, Paige, let me just finish. All right, he's making me feel like there was something he carried around in his pockets all the time, Paige. I don't worry about what they say. My aim is on point. I know what I'm doing, and I do it for a reason. Trust me. Remember, just go see. You guys are friends on my page. Go see my page about that little thing where it says, this is why I do what I do, and your approval is not needed. But I'm very protective as well, too. So when someone tries to come and basically, that's basically what they're doing, like thiefing energy. Like, you're not just going to get a double dose of what you're giving out. You're not going to be able to get any off of anybody here either. Okay. Yes, he did. Okay. He's talking about whatever this was in his pocket. And also, he's making me feel like there's some coin or something as well that he had in his pocket all the time. Because I feel him flipping it, like, in his hand. So he wants me to point that out to you. Okay. I didn't know there would be so many people here. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Where are we going from here? Oh, I didn't realize that girl had been up all up in here trying to poison you guys. Ay, ay, ay. Huh. How can you do it by lie? Wait, let me just address this real quick. Okay, number one, you still don't believe in this. Then what are you doing here? Think about it. You're investing your time into what? Being able to just type on a board? There's plenty of boards out there. So number one, logically, without my intuition tells me, okay, that you're full of shit, that there's something there for you, okay? But you know what? It's fear that stops you. You're more fearful that indeed it wouldn't be true. But something in you keeps coming to the surface saying, yeah, that's what this is. And if I'll tell you right now, I know my abilities and I know how accurate I am. So if you're over here throwing shade like that here, well, guess what? Okay. I can only imagine what you do in your personal life. All right. Anyway, let's go to. Francis McHenry. You need a creative outlet for your stuff. That's what the problem is, all right? You have this creative energy about you, and you feel stuck because it has no outlet. So guess what happens? You have these creative bursts. It doesn't go anywhere, and it wells up. A creative burst, and it wells up. And guess what happens? You get depressed. You're drowning in your own creative energy. Find an outlet for it. Start writing again, because they're telling me, all right? And that will help it enormously, all right? Also being outside. And this is, I love you too, Jamie. I haven't talked to you in so long. I've been thinking about you. Okay, Gail, it popped in earlier. So, are you looking to talk to your brother? Because that's who's coming through. And Jessica. Yes. Was your son a twin? No. Did you? Yes. Not because your grandma sent her. Let's say she picked her. Yeah. Your book, it's going to do fairly well is the way I'm hearing it. Fairly well. But I feel like you'll be pleasantly pleased because I feel like you've set the bar low for yourself as based on kind of the combination of everything. All right. And also the environment and the things that it's going into. I don't need any, just so you guys know, because I'm reading the stuff, I don't need the belief in order to make it real. Like, you know, I've made many skeptics, I don't want to say made, but I've brought out the truth in many skeptics so they could see that indeed this is the way it was. So to me, it's no sweat off my back. In other words, you can say whatever you want, but the truth is still going to be the truth, period, no matter what you do. Does the coin I mentioned mean anything? Yes. Yeah, Christine, the announcer. Yes, we have Gail. Um, Yeah, Gail, your brother's coming through and he's talking a mile a minute. And it's funny because I'm familiar enough with the situation because of my Aunt Brenda. But I only remember from way back when we were kids, you know, and we lived and they lived in Oakdale, in Nana Dot's house. But I don't remember him talking. Maybe I just wasn't paying attention, but I feel like he's just talking. All right? Like he's like, wants to get everything out like right now. He's talking about the month of October, Gail, and the number 13. And he said something about, does he have kids? Does he have boys? My boys? All right. And also, did he have something wrong? I'm getting sharp pains, like where your diaphragm is, just slightly down into the left. I feel I just got a sharp pain right there. Okay. All right, well, this is the way he's making me feel. Now, did he have... So, bringing up October, he's bringing up the number 13 and the number 24, he just said. But I feel this sharp pain, like, down there somewhere. Yes, Paige, he is. They're happy when you're happy, okay? They live vicariously through us. That's why they call it the spirit of God. And I use that term loosely as far as God goes, because it could be, to me, it's universal consciousness. It's, you know, this divine cosmic comic mind type thing, okay? So they literally take the ride with us, if that makes sense. Okay, well, because I keep getting these, it's like this pain. It's driving me nuts because, wait, let me adjust my, oops, hold on. All right, well, because he's talking about my boys, and then he also said the number 13, the number 24, and he's talking about the month of October. Yes, I do private readings. You can see my page. No. I know them. Those are my cousins. No. I talk to my uncle all the time, my Uncle Spanky. I'm talking about your brother. No, it's not pain in the legs. Nope. It's localized, and I felt it, and it feels sharp. Gail, do you want to ask? You know, and it's funny because I know enough about the situation because I'm obviously, you know, I'm related. I feel like he's going the long way around to validate, which drives me absolutely insane. But I know it's possible because I read from my sister's absolute best friend since she was like 4. And I brought through all this stuff and she just kept looking at me with this blank stare like, I don't know. Then she hit me up after she spoke to her mother and she's like, hey. She said, my mother validated every single thing you said. My sister Allison's friend, Tanisha. So, yeah. And there's something, it's digestive. It makes me feel like... It's like diverticulitis type thing. Okay, then I would say yes. He's talking about my boys. He's talking so much and so fast. Have a good night, Crystal. Do you have any questions, Gail, that you'd like to ask? He's making me feel like there's one of your kids that you need to keep an eye on. One of the girls. Let me write this down because I don't want to. And I think you know, Gail, what I'm talking about. But he wants you to keep an eye on her and just keep an ear out. Your dad? Did he like Nat King Cole? Hi, Lisa. I said hi to you earlier, but I think sometimes I see you guys join and then I say it too quick for you to hear me. I'm seeing Nat King Cole and Natalie Cole in my mind, so... Okay. Yeah, he's going like this. Like, being silly, like... You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, like, that's his stuff. That's his... his jam, so to speak. All right? And that's what he's bringing through. He said, I got moves. He's funny. Debbie, you still there? I thought you were going to bed. That's why I didn't say anything. Chances are what, Christina? You want me to buy you one of those little magic eight balls? And it can tell you not likely. There's a cool story behind that, actually, because it actually was produced for exactly what I'm talking about. But yeah, like this. He's like, come on. Like in the kitchen, like, you know you want to dance with me type thing. So that's what he's showing me. All right. I'm only going to do a couple more, and then I have got to go get the baby from my father, or else he's going to just be a pain. Donna Howard, so you said hear from your son's friend Danny and his mom got on here? So where's his mom? Kayla, Carrie's looking for you. I have tarot cards, but honestly, unless I'm doing like on my group pages, I'll do quick like one card pull type things, like ask a question, one card pull, boom. I just did this not too long ago just to like sharpen those skills a little bit. But when I'm reading, it just comes through like direct connect. So sometimes, think about it, I have to do this, shuffle, lay it on, boom. It takes more time. I can just give you the information. So if you have a question, you can ask it. I don't need to pull cards, so to speak. Yes, Lucy, pets do come through at times. Who, and Paige Schindel, who told you had a bad aura? Or who said anything about a bad aura? I always question people that say things like that, because if you're not coming through from a healing process or saying, you know, trying to bring it back into balance, it always makes me think, okay, what are you getting out of this by telling somebody something like that? That's what it makes me think. It doesn't mean that there isn't truth to it. It just means it's a lot of it is the way that you present things. Of course Aaron's here, but he's like sitting in the back like this. Doesn't want to say anything because he's like, oh no. Joanne's going to be upset. And I talk to you guys all the time. All right, where was I? Okay, the person who was talking wanted to talk to their son's friend, Daniel, but the mother was here. I still haven't seen. Michelle Carvalho, she took her life because she was hearing voices. That's why. I'm a little worried about her, Michelle. Because I think I saw a post not too long ago and that's going through my head. Even though I think she comes from strong stock and she'll come back from it, but I feel like there may be some things that she may regret type thing. Okay, Donna, well, I'm going to keep going. Let's see. I'm only going to do a couple more. And let's see. Yamari, because you have been patiently waiting and you have even held the door for numerous people on here. So, Yamari, what is your question? And Christopher Whitney, absolutely smoking cigarettes, and they look like the Benson and Hedges brown ones. Yes, you. Yamari. Is that how you say it? Yamari? I don't want to pronounce it wrong. All right, so Yamari's next, and then I'll choose one more that I'm drawn to, and then I've got to get the baby to bed and then answer all these messages. But I will do this again because this went well. Yamari, do you have a question? Oh, I thought, I looked, said, hi, Mom. I'm like, wait a minute. And then I looked, I'm like, no, that's not Keenan. You don't say that, Kayla, huh? I'm going to do this again. I'll do it every, I don't know. I don't want to, I don't like to say things and not do what I'm saying I'm going to do. So yeah, like this, just like that, Kayla. That's what I said earlier. He's in the back like this. He's looking at my brother like, you believe this? Yamari wants to know if her grandma was waiting, if her grandma was waiting for her to pass away. Okay. Did you not get there in time, Yamari? Is that what you're asking me? I'm from the daycare. My daycare? The daycare that the baby goes to? Paul Mall. I knew it was the old school cigarettes, but I see Benson and Hedges because those are the brown ones. But Paul Mall, my nanny used to smoke those. Those funky filters, they look like little, look like a star on the inside. Yes, you did get there in time, Yamari. Yeah, but I feel like the whole ride over, you know what it reminds me of? When I was going to my brother that was murdered, I was there when his second son was born, and I was at work, and he was calling me, and I remember I was on 195 on my way to St. Luke's from Wareham, and he's like, Joey, she's 8 centimeters, you gotta come now. I said, I'm going 95 on the highway, I can't get there. So that's what's flashing in my mind. So I feel like you're like this, like your hands are like, oh my God, please let me get there. Like, you knew that this was where it was gonna go. Like, you were worried the whole time and thinking about it, that you weren't gonna be there on time, yes? I feel like that it was already set in stone. In other words, you were going to be there, all right? So it's not necessarily she was waiting for you. It's just like there was something, that drive in you that already, almost like when I read the future, you knew that that's where it was, where you were going to be, okay? Yeah. Did you not call her grandma? Because it's not coming through as grandma. All right, there's two more that I'm going to do after this, and I'll tell you. Okay, yeah, that's what I feel like. You're like, oh God, like, please let me get there on time, okay? All right, yeah, because it didn't come through as grandma, all right? She taught you how to cook, like, beans and rice or something like that? Like the old school way? With the iron pot, the cast iron? Yeah. Okay, well, because you guys aren't answering quick enough, but she's making me feel like she's very proud of you, okay? She said you retain, she's making me feel like you retain that, how do you say it? Like, not pizzazz, what do you, like, you're sassy, but you're responsible, okay? And you're very protective, all right? And this is something she admires. And she said that you're not afraid to really, basically stand up for yourself, okay? And she's saying that you're going to do great things in your life. All right? She said you get it from her. Noelia? Is that how you say it? Chris said, who smoked a brown cigarette? Yeah, that's the Benson and Hedges. So that could be coming in. But somebody else said Paul Mall. Paul Mall's those white ones with the funky filter that my nana would smoke. Where's Noelia? N-O-E-L-I-A. You're welcome. Oh, her name's Noelia too? Oh, she knows. I got you, Stephanie. You're next, and then that's it. She had hip problems. Is that how you say your name? Because it's driving me nuts that I'm not saying, like, if I'm not saying, is it Noelia? Am I saying that right? Okay. But she had hip problems. Oh, Chris, I know who you are. I just put the whole thing together, and Aaron's over here laughing at me. I only have like 1,000, if you think about it, all the people that are in here, and then all the people related to all those people, and all those, the people around them,